Hello and greetings from Iceland, but here is a sample of the footage I shot in my journey to the volcano last Sunday. But I've been on a photo tour for almost a week and I just got back yesterday, but the highlight was of course the volcano. And it's actually a bit hard for me to walk up there since I have to carry with me sensitive and heavy equipment like my zoom lens that I used for this opening shot. But many of my viewers know the standard webcam look. But this is the real deal, all the juicy details. And I shot plenty of this. This is just a sample. And this is how the car park looked when I took off 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And I didn't come back until 1 o'clock after midnight. And it was a record-breaking number of visitors that day, or 6,700 people. But many needed some help, since the trail that is fairly good covers only about half of the way. And the rest is just rocks, but getting better though. So every day people are being helped back from the mountain with some injuries, often due to bad shoes, but the best story from last weekend was the girl that arrived on her slippers, but she claimed that the color of them matched her outdoor outfit better than the walking shoes. But she was of course thinking about the photo that she would get up there for the social media. And as for the general status up there, the lava volume is already enough to take off from the valley, but it's not moving a lot though. But as we know from last year, lava ponds can take off very suddenly, and by time we will see the lava move over this little pass to the east, as I just mapped in a recent video I'm linking to. But then, the news of the day is the decreasing activity up there. And when the lava ejection goes below 3 cubic meters per second, it's more or less game over. And we are only slightly over that limit now. So is the volcano going to die on us? And since this is well-situated eruption that has brought regular guests and idiots nothing but joy, it would be a total bummer for the travel industry to turn off the Christmas lights well before Christmas. But this is not just about the lights, it's also about the mood. To go up there is also about to look at the people looking at the volcano, see the excitement and get in the mood. And in a way, this is like going to a football game. The crowd is cheering during the highlights of the evening when the lava fountains peak. So what if we would add an Icelandic football commentator into this package? Because they are a part of the mood. And this is how they sound in Icelandic when things get hot. And as for those clips I shot with my zoom lens, I have been thinking about to edit them together with some music into a long video, so it's plenty from where this came from. And I shot this at 60 frames per second so I can slow it down. And the zoom is ranging from 200 to 500 millimeters. And since I used an external microphone, the sound is usable in some cases. But like always, the wind up there is quite boring. And then it's only one thing to do, and it's to go for the still photos. But my plan was to freeze the lava, like when I'm shooting at the water droplets. And many of those photos came out just fine. But I've just started to go over them and a week on the road is a month in front of the computer. But when it comes to the drone, I took it with me of course, things were a bit more tricky. So I was experimenting, see how close I would dare to go. I did see one drone take a dive into the lava, but I heard it somewhere that there is this magnetic field around the eruption that is messing up the navigation system in drones. And I lost control once while flying directly over the lava, but the signal kicked in again and that made me very happy. And I also needed to learn about the settings, but I don't fly over volcanoes that often. And when I'm shooting using only a little screen, I won't be sure what I'm getting until I get back home. And in this case, the first results are promising. But what I've been showing you is just a teaser. I will have to figure out how to edit some of the videos I shot. And this wasn't the only volcano I dropped by, even though the others didn't have any of the red stuff. So it is more than plenty to come. But it is, however, a priority to follow up on the ongoing eruption and do the other videos later, when and if things cool down on the Reykjanes Peninsula. Our experts did expect a similar pattern as last year when this new eruption started, but I am hearing some doubts now, so there is no answer to the question for how long time will this last. All we can do is use the time well and get the most from this unique chance to see Mother Earth in the making without any serious risk for people or infrastructure. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.